October's Jeff Lindsay in the garage. We is Sunday the 15th of April. It's been really bad weather. We just been kind of in the house doing nothing. And just got the fever to come out and do a little something. It's about 2:30 p.m. And the first thing we decided we would do is try to find the brake lines, the flex lines that go from the frame mounts to the calipers. That's something we don't have on the car yet. So we were able to locate both lines and both brackets, thankfully. Passenger side one and the driver's side one. We're gonna put them in the blast cabinet, clean them up, paint them. We'll definitely have to order new lines. These are 15 inches, and it's got the little banjo bolt deal on one end and just a little hook up there for the hard line on the other end. So we were able to find a kit that'll go from that area and follow the subframe to that area, and it includes the short pieces and the proportioning valve. I mean, you can buy it all. It's all preformed, pre-made. The little kit with all the brake lines, I can get it for like $50. So that's probably what we're gonna do instead of trying to bend our own, just get the ones already made up. They're cheap. Of course, that'll leave us a bunch of 3/16 that we don't need, but that's okay. We'll pass that along to somebody that's going to use it, that can use it. We'll go from there. That's all we're doing. Just going to clean up some brackets, stuff we've got to have, and get them mounted on the car. All right, we'll bring you back. All right, YouTubers, we got our brake line brackets sandblasted, painted, and mounted onto the subframe. We've got our driver's side caliper painted, dry, and ready to stick back on there as soon as it gets good and dry. We'll probably do that in the next day or two. Next thing we're going to do is order our brake line kit that'll tie all this in and come up to the master cylinder. We'll go ahead and get all that in, figure out our mounting points. You can kind of tell where those little double holes, everywhere the double holes are, that's where they're going to pretty much mount too, so shouldn't be too hard to figure out. We've got our manual, we can refer to it as well. Once we get that, I think the next thing we need to do is go ahead and clean up good inside there and figure out exactly what we want to do for a headliner. I do not want to try to make the headliner with the car flipped over. It'd be much, much easier on me to do it just like this. We can make the headliner all but the final finish cover piece. We can get our mounting points, all that. Plus, we've got to order our trim pieces for the headliner. So, still a lot of work to do while the car's up in the air and flipped over, but we'll get it done. The other thing that we're thinking seriously about doing is we're thinking about doing something with the firewall. It looks bad. I don't like the Raptor liner on it. I may end up scrapping this whole front part of this thing and clean it all off and do something totally different. The other thing that I don't like is on this driver's side where that was beat back out. I should have changed that piece a long time ago. I'm not 100% sure exactly what I'm going to do, but we will not leave it looking like this. I promise you that. This thing will not look like that. We may end up making a piece once all this is took off. We may end up just making a piece that'll go in here and weld it in, and it'll cover all that up and be nice and neat. Have one little bin here. It shouldn't be too hard of a piece to make. And then we can get all the Raptor liner off of there and get the firewall done right. I got a different idea in mind for that. The delete plate, all that's probably gonna get scrapped. So, we just going back, changing our mind, doing all kind of crazy stuff, but that's all right. We'll get it one day. All right, YouTube, we'll bring you back when we have some progress. All right, Tubers. Monday the 16th. Out in the garage some, about 4:30 p.m. We've got the driver's side caliper done and back on the car. Looks fine. We've got the passenger side left. That is the last one out of the four that we need to get done. Of course, our brackets we finished up yesterday, got those back on the car for the brake lines. The flex line that runs from the caliper on each side to the bracket, we found those from the same company, Inline Tube, on eBay. We got those ordered. They should be in by the end of the week, by the weekend maybe. We can get those knocked out. The one that follows from the passenger side all the way across and goes up to the master cylinder, that is a single line that ties in there, goes around, comes up, and ties in. I'm just not sure about putting that on yet. And the reason why is if I do, it's just going to be kind of in the way of everything else that we try to do. So we're going to hold off on that for now. The brackets from the under the subframe, we know we're going to pull those, so we'll probably go ahead and do that this afternoon. They will be in the way of headers, and we're definitely going with headers on this car. So we're going to get those off, out of the way, put them to the side. We won't need them. And that's just kind of what we're up to. Just a lot of loose end stuff, a lot of stuff that's got to be done. I know it's nothing very interesting, but it's got to be done. So we're going to document it as we go so we'll know where we're headed and what's next. All right, we'll bring you along. All right, Tuber's got the brackets pulled off that we don't need in the way. And got the other caliper pulled off and painted. We'll stick it back on there in the morning. That's pretty much it for right now. We kind of scratched around on this thing trying to figure out what we're going to do. I think we got a plan for it. We're going to cover all that mess up. We're going to strip it all off, paint it good, and then we're going to make a piece that'll cover every bit of that old dented mess up. And then we're going to strip this Raptor liner off all the way to probably this line right here, right across there. All that's going to be kind of underneath the car, so we're going to let that stay. And probably what we'll do is to try to tie this in, maybe run a little thin line of seam sealer there just to try to help hold that in so maybe it won't peel back. That stuff stuck pretty good. It's going to have to be ground off, which that'll be fine. We'll take our time, we'll get it off, and we'll make it look right. All right, Tubers, when we have progress, you know we're going to bring you along. All right. All right, Tubers, Jeff Lynn's in the garage with you. Wednesday the 18th, and we've got the subframe put back together, calipers painted up, rotors cleaned, and hopefully that'll stop that little flash rust issue that we had. We did take those braces off that we knew from just what we've been reading that were probably going to be in the way of headers. So, and I think we mentioned that. But that's what we did so far today. And I like that a lot better. So subframe and rear end hopefully is ready to go back under the car as soon as we figure out what we're going to do up front here. And obviously with the headliner issue, that's kind of what we're going to tackle. All right. When we figure something out, we'll bring you back. All right, YouTube. Jeff Lynn's in the garage with you Saturday afternoon late, April 21. We hadn't done a thing today. Just laid around, been sorry. We kind of got out a little bit ago. And we're going to take a break from the car. We got our brake lines, our brackets, all on, hooked up to the calipers on the front subframe. We've got all that done on the rear end back there. And brake lines, fuel lines on the car, we've documented and showed that. We just need a break from that. We need to do a little something different to keep us interested. So we pulled the motor transmission out from under the table. We're gonna pull the transmission off of the motor, get the motor on the motor stand, and we're gonna start pulling it apart. Main reason is I wanna see what we've got. I wanna know if I've got a 305 or a 350. Everything that I know about these things is it's really hard to tell from the outside, other than looking up the casting number, and I've already done that. It is a 3970014, and everything on the internet that I can find says that that's a 350. Two or four bolt main, which doesn't matter to me either way. The guy that we got, or that my son bought the car from, told him that the guy he bought the car from had just freshened up this motor. I doubt that very seriously. If you look at all the orange overspray on the tube, on the transmission, he didn't do anything to this motor, I don't think. He probably took the valve covers off and sprayed paint all over it, made it look like he had done something, but to the kind of halfway trained eye, if you just look at all the orange paint all over everything, you can tell this wasn't painted while it was being built. So I doubt seriously the motor's worth a toot like it is. Even if we thought that it had been freshened up, we still got a lot of stuff we're gonna do to the motor anyway. We're not gonna turn it into a race car. We're not gonna turn it into a high horsepower motor. I would like to have more than 220 or 30 horsepower though. So there's some things that we'll do to it, probably different heads, obviously cam and lifters. Not sure about this Edelbrock intake. Not sure what exactly it is, but that's what it is. Not sure how old it is. Not sure. I don't understand all the terminology about single plane, dual plane intakes, that type of thing. Obviously, this ignition is shot, which you can see it's got busted. Probably, I don't know. I mean, there's no way to speculate on how that happened. But we are definitely going to tear this thing down just to break up the monotony of building the car. I know it's really not time for that, and this stuff is going to be in the way for the remainder of this car build, but that's okay. I'm good with it. I just need to do something different, so that's the plan. We're going to try to pull the transmission off this afternoon and maybe get out here early in the morning if we feel like it, and put this on the stand and start the process of getting this thing tore down. And when we do that, we'll bring you along. It might be a different video, but we'll bring you back. All right, Tuber, it's about 6 p.m. on Saturday, still the 21st. Transmission, torque converter, down to the flex plate, flywheel, whatever you want to call it. We're gonna pull that in the morning and go ahead and set this thing up on the motor stand and clean up a little bit, roll this thing over and get that big table in here and go ahead and start tearing this thing apart, see what kind of innards we've got. I know this video hadn't been very good, just a lot of little stuff or a little bit of little stuff, and not much interesting stuff, but it is what it is. It's all got to be done at some point. So that's where we at, what we're doing, letting you know. We're still kicking. We're gonna kick this motor tomorrow. We're gonna try to put in a full day's worth of work. So we'll be back with you then with another video. We'll upload this one, let you see what's going on. From the Rusty Metal Garage, stay tuned. Wanna thank everybody for watching. Thanks all the subscribers. There's been a few new ones. Seem like all the time you'll get a few here and there. And we appreciate it. Appreciate everybody watching. We'll do it again.